What's up, everybody? Welcome back for another episode of the DCUO Sourcecast. That's right, episode 209. 209, if we make it to 210, and all that, then I'm going to have to keep doing this, I guess. First off, what's up, everybody? Welcome back for another episode of the DCUO Sourcecast. That's right, episode 209. Yeah, I'm a pro. 209 episodes doing this. I still got to remember to mute my stream. Anyways, anyways, you guys can hear Crappy is back with me this week. Say hello, Crappy.
Hello, Crappy.
And we have a special guest, a returning guest. I don't know if they're going to stay or not and all that. Maybe just one of those little things, you know, that happens every once in a while. But Brittany's back, guys.
Hello.
Yeah. Get everybody excited about that. Yeah, every week people have been asking me, well, where's Brittany at? When's Brittany coming back? where's Brittany at? So there's the question. Where you been at, Brittany, and when are you coming back?
I've been around, and I don't know.
You don't know. Alright, fine then. Well, just be that way. This week, pretty eventful week here. I know the stream just started clunking for me. This is all Maggie's fault. Everybody, Maggie,
at the beginning of the stream,
before we started up, she said, I hope your internet's going all right. I'm going to go, okay. She jinxed it. It's her fault if anything happens.
Maybe you should steal your internet and your neighbor's internet.
You're an asshole. Shut up. Nobody said anything yet, so I'm guessing we're still alive.
Yeah, I refreshed it. It's cool. All
right, cool. So this week, I know at least Crappy has not spent very much time on DCUO this week. Another game that dropped a DLC on us.
Hey, well, when these changes happen.
I just thought it was funny that, like, the first day that DLC dropped, everybody was having connection issues.
The first couple hours?
Yeah.
That's just like any game.
I was seeing tweets all over the place, and I was like, oh, we're brothers again. everybody who left DCUO to go play Destiny, you know, hey, we're brothers and sisters again. Y'all dealing with those lag issues.
Every game, like, seems to always have issues, you know, when you release new content, you know, and everybody thinks it's just DC Universe, and they're like, oh, DC sucks. I'm like, no, man. Pretty much every game I play is messed up at some point.
That's something.
Very rarely does stuff happen perfect.
You know, when Brittany was on the show before, too, we used to joke about that all the time. So every other game has a perfect launch. And a perfect DLC drop, except for DCUO. Okay, sure, buddy.
It's only DC.
But so yeah, we just start getting into it, right? I mean, you know, we had a big announcement this week from the developers. They did a nice little live stream on Wednesday here with dropping the whole stats revamp.
Yeah. That's the surprise I'm telling everybody that I had.
Yeah, this is the surprise. That's the surprise you're telling everybody? Yep. Hold on a second.
Everybody gets nerfed, and now Nature and Electric are good again.
How does it feel knowing that you collectively nerfed every other power?
That's awesome. I'm proud of that. I complained so much, and so did everybody else that was Nature and Electric, that we got everybody nerfed. Take that, mental guy.
All right, hold on. Here we go. So anyways, all right, we're back. Devs dropped the stats revamp. live stream and forum work in progress post today, where they detailed, well, went into detail, some detail, about all the things that they're changing up here with revamping the stats, removing advanced mechanics and weapon mastery bonuses. That took everybody by surprise right there. Enhancing supercharges, modifying power and power regen, removing power points, ending mid-range. That took everybody by surprise, those last two.
Oh, thank God.
And preparing for the future. So let's start off here. Let's talk about the overview on the stats revamp. So first of all, they're removing the CR differential. How happy are you guys?
Oh, I'm thrilled.
It's about damn time.
That was a terrible idea, that.
It really was.
Not only for support roles and DPS, I mean, it made it a nightmare for tanks. You know, when you were under-geared as a tank, just going to new content, you were extra weak for no reason.
Yeah. See, for me, the whole thing with the CR differential was, I mean, it kind of killed the replayability of the game. Because once you got that gear, there was nothing else you really had to do. You know, once you got to the max CR, there was nothing you really had to do until the next piece of content came out. You know, which, you know, made a lot of these guys, that's why we're seeing so many, you know, like 175 CRs with like 90 skill points. Or 100.
Yeah, I just hate, I hated that too. And like, I could care less if I'm top DPS in a raid, but I mean, the people who are max CR with literally 40 skill points and them being like top DPS just because of the power they are, because everyone's so equal and they're using ice or something stupid like that. I mean, it's just a combination of the whole, someone was pressing one button, they have 40 skill points, but they could still do good because everything was just dumb easy.
Yeah. And, you know, and it really, you know, pushed more towards the whole, you know, stacking the DPSs and everything. And
I hate the group compositions that we have now.
Yeah.
I miss when we had two trolls. You know, when you put all those DPS in a room, I mean, you could just burn through a whole bunch of stuff super quick and avoid a whole bunch of mechanics. And still, like, it's just, it's hard to design content around that just because how powerful we were and how many DPS we could put in a group.
Yeah. Britt, how do you think groups are going to be, you know, having to be put together now once this drops, like for raids like DWF, for instance?
It all depends on how the power rework goes. My guess would be, though, that you would most likely need two trollers. I would hope, at least in a raid setting, that whatever they come up with, DPSs won't be self-sufficient on their own in a raid. Because basically, a troller was only powering the healer and the tank. I mean, no DPS in a raid really needed any power, so
yeah.
I'm hoping that that ends up changing that. I still don't think it's going to change the healer composition setup. I think it's still going to be a solo healer until the content actually changes that would make it so that it requires another healer. Just healers have way too much resto, and the fact that they're so powerful on their own, I don't think that's going to change until the content changes. But since we're not able to burn, well, I'm guessing we're not going to be able to burn through content like we have in the past, that might actually change because fights will be longer, there will be more time to mess up, you know, things like that could make it so that you would want to bring another healer in there just to make it easier on the rest of the group. So,
right. Right. Plus, especially when you're dealing with like nature healers with their bug form, they had their own AM.
Yeah,
you
know, that was really helpful.
I was soloing stuff with the bug.
Yeah.
Like, if people died, you know, like, we did the elite alert, and when we were, like, pretty under-geared-ish, and everybody died at the end, and I soloed it with the bug, finished off the boss all by myself. I was like, I don't even need anybody. I got the bug. I just punched this guy to death. It took a really long time, but
yeah,
it happened.
So, okay, so then they're also going to be smoothing out how you gain stats over the course of your character's life and redistributing where those stats come from. So they're going to make it so you're not like, jumping forward, you know, like, or going at a crawl at certain points. And then changing the way those, where your stats are coming from, They're doing things like they're going to make mods worth more. They're going to make mods, you know, give you more stats, like, you know, a lot more stats.
Crafted mods.
Yeah.
Better be a significant amount more than synthetics.
Yeah.
Not to take away from anybody. I mean, but it takes a little bit of time to make a mod or just, I mean, a crafted mod should just be more than a synthetic mod.
Yeah, that's something I've brought
up. I'd like to get away from the easy handout stuff, you know, since we're getting rid of AMs and weapon mastery. You know, and like I see some people don't have the time, you know, and they get some synthetics, but at least make the crafted mods a good amount of difference.
Well, I mean, if you don't have the time, you shouldn't be rewarded the same as somebody who does have the time to do that.
Yeah, like, I feel the same way.
Yeah,
because crafted mod, you know, I mean, because it's only like 5 marks for a synthetic mod. But crafted mods, you know, you've got to get the bites. You've got to get the equipment interface. You've got to get the focusing element. And then you got to get any number of simples and the complex, which, you know, because of the way salvage works and all, is completely left up to RNG. I don't know about you guys, but I know for a fact I've got one alt whose bank and inventory is just filled up with simples. Because I've been like knocking on wood and, you know, kind of, you know, semi pushing for a R&D plan to make a complex out of simples, so I could just start crafting complex whenever I need them instead. But yeah, it's kind of ridiculous, the costs and everything with the mods the way they are. I mean, if it wasn't for like exceptional recovery kits, there's like no way in hell I'd be able to mod any of my alts. Or at least, you know, most of them. Or, you know, they'd have like alphas and beta or betas in their gear and not the 7 mods that I've been putting in them. But, I mean, I know, Brittany, you don't stand still on the game. You go out and farm, whenever, you know, in between queues and everything like that. There's a lot of people, though, that don't farm at all. And I think this would be like a good way to let them know that, hey, you know, not only are you getting better mods out of this, but, you know, you go out and farm, you know, you can get feats done, too.
I'm sure they can stop hanging around in the watchtower for an hour not doing anything.
Watchtower all day long.
Pick up a few bits here and there and be good, you know? Doesn't really take that much time.
Maybe if there were extra bits in the watchtower, we could farm.
Well, at that point, you might as well just freaking have them for sale so they can just buy them. Oh, wait, they do on the broker. Hey,
look at that. Yeah.
Someone who puts more time in, though, should get a better reward. Like, if you care about your character and care about the game, you know, and I mean, I have no problem doing it. Like, if I don't know. I just don't have any remorse for those people who say, oh, I don't have the time, blah, 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 blah. Like, I don't know how you don't have the time. Like, you could get on. And there's always that you don't have to raid and do all this stuff every day. You know, raids happen once a week. You do your raids once a week, and then what do you do for the other rest of the week? I mean, you could take a couple minutes out, farm every day, get some bites, no problem.
Yeah. But even then, but look how long the crafting system has been out. I mean, from whenever you started to play until now, you didn't have any time to mod your tune, like, at all.
Right.
Yeah.
Something.
Yeah.
You could sell something, buy some bikes, you know.
I have 5 tunes and they're all modded for both roles, so I don't what?
I got you beat.
Well, that's all I have. I don't feel like making any more, but I could model my level 3 alts. Like you've had this amount of time to to do this, like Krabby said, I don't. what are you doing? Like, I don't get it.
But basically, what are you doing with your time on this game?
Right. It doesn't take 5 hours
at all. Not much to do.
She's right though. It really doesn't. I mean, I've gone out and farmed for the time. Like, I've got a route, right? But every once in a while, when I like want a lot of bits fast, I'll pop a scanner and I'll like do my route and I'll go like expand out a few like 4 or 5 blocks with it too. And you know, in like the time it takes me to use like two scanners, I've been able to farm, you know, like 7 bytes worth of bits. So I mean, it doesn't really take that long, and that's like the prime bits. I mean, if I'm looking at, you know, like making tenacious or vengeful bites, you know, I mean, I could make enough for a whole mod in like 15 minutes, especially if you use the catalyst to, you know, transmute the bits over. That's another thing I don't think people really look at either. You know, there's ways to, like, you know, say, oh, man, I go out farming. All I do is I got all these blue bits and nothing to do with them. Transmute the damn things. It goes towards your create feat, for crying out loud.
Yeah.
You know how many people don't have those feats? Because, you don't know, I don't need mods. What do you need mods for?
Oh, I know.
You know, and, like, now that they're revamping all the stats and taking away all this stuff, I would really not like to see us have all the, I don't want to say easy mode stuff, but like, I'd like to put the grind back into some stuff. Yeah. And it's not even really a grind, but just put the effort into things, you know?
See, the thing I'm looking forward to is people actually putting the appropriate mods in their sockets. Like, you know, the DPS that has, you know, a health 5 synthetic mod in a blue socket. Really, bro? All right, great. You're getting the affinity. That's awesome. But sir, get yourself a precision health or a might health.
Listen,
you know,
he's probably ice. He has ice elemental 3 in his head. He doesn't need any mods, man. Come on now.
That's another thing too. We'll get to here in a minute. But next up, also, they're going to be revamping the stat related skill points. Now, a lot of you guys may be wondering what that means. Currently, the skill points that grant stats require you to master different weapons, going deep into trees you don't want to go into. So they're consolidating all the stats into one tree. Actually, it's kind of like two trees.
I'm iffy on this.
No, wait, it is one tree. All right, so here's a screen cap from the live stream here. The first time they showed us the stat points tree, where you can see that, you know, we've got the crit attack damage right here. This is the crit attack. I believe this is the crit attack chance. We got heal magnitude, heal chance, and I believe one of these is going to be power heal chance, power crit chance, and I'm not sure what the other one is. I didn't see them highlight over all of them.
Something I'm interested in is, are now people with less skill points going to be able to get better stats? So is that going to enable people with lesser skill points to have better stats than they did? You know, like, that's something.
Well, I mean, like, if you're specking in any role, if you're specking in any role, you want to go for, you know, like the crit chances first.
Like, how it is now, though, really benefits you to have more skill points, because you have to spec into all that other crap. You know, it takes up your skill points. And while it does kind of stink, I mean, that's kind of the meaning for more skill points in a way.
Well, you're always going to want to have more skill points. I don't think that if you have, like, 100 skill points, you're going to be content with just having 100 when you have somebody who has 200. I don't think it's gonna make them better than they were before. I just think it's a redistribution, I guess, of how the skill points are, and it makes those that have more skill points more powerful.
Yeah, I mean,
I guess it's just gonna be something to actually see how many skill points. Like, I'm in favor of change and stuff like that, because it does suck to spec in the weapon combos I'm never going to use and essentially just kind of waste those skill points.
Right. Because, I mean, to speak on, you know, I think to add a little bit onto what Brittany was saying, though, like,
I mean, sound real dickhandish, you know, I don't want someone with less skill points than me.
You will be crappy. You'll never be good.
You got somebody who only has like 100 skill points, though, you know, and they put all the majority of their skill points into their crit attack chance and crit attack damage. I mean, how big are those crits actually going to be, you know, when their might's only 300? You know?
is there going to be more crits than there is now?
They did say something about how stats were going to scale up as content was released. Everything's going to scale up with you as you increase your skill points, as you progress, things are going to scale up with you. But as far as I know, there's not going to be like a cap or anything like that.
I heard there's going to be a cap on stats.
Well, like right now, you see right here, and here's another screenshot I grabbed to illustrate this a little bit better. 287 skill points and everything. You know, he's able to throw like skill points and all this stuff. Right now, the most you can spec into the bottom six right here, these six right here, the most you can spec into each of those is 170 skill points. So, is that number going to be increased over time? I believe so. I believe they'll gradually increase that up. You know, as you know, more skill points become available in the game. As far as the crits up here, I have no doubt in my mind that they'll probably end up doing the same thing with those. I don't see why they wouldn't. Because eventually, you know, that you're going to get to a point where it would get to a point where, you know, I mean, are you going to start capping people? Then, you know, now we're talking about an entirely different issue that a lot of people are not happy with, you know, when it comes to seasonal events.
I love stat caps and seasonal events.
Yeah, we lost Brittany.
She's having technical difficulties too.
She may be. So yeah, I don't know if they're gonna be. I don't think they're gonna be putting a cap on the stats at all. So I think eventually, you know, you're gonna be rising up there. My thing is though, you know, is this is gonna take a lot of thought. You know, specking into some of these things now, when it comes to. You know,
you just gotta spec in everything that makes you pew pew pew.
Yeah, but I'm talking about when it comes into like support roles and everything, because like you know for trollers, you know you want to have the power crit heal chance. Obviously, you're gonna want to have as much you know vit, a lot of vit too. But you know if you like dump everything into vit, you know and forget your dominance, then how are you gonna CC ads?
Usually the gear gives you enough dom. But I know what you mean. Maybe now the gear won't always give you enough.
Yeah, maybe this would like you know, this will add into this will go into like more skillful
More skillful specking
like, and put and not only that, but the way you put way people put groups together too is you know, you go into the raid now with two trollers. One troller is the main troll, he's got the POT, you know. He's the you know the main you know kind of dump guy, and he's the one who's dealing the debuffs out. And then you got another troll who's helping with all the crowd control stuff.
Yeah, you know maybe the gear wouldn't give you enough dom, so then maybe one of the trolls would have to spec into more dom, so he could be doing some CC. You know, and the other guy had. More white focus loadout. I don't know. It could just open up different windows.
Yeah.
I just have to really see. You know, like the information is there, but yeah, it's a little vague.
It's going to take a lot of experimenting with this stuff when it hits test. to figure out what, you know, good loadouts are, and, you know, what good way, what, not so much loadouts, but, you know, good ways to spec
good ways skill to points. Spec. It depends on the gear, too, you know, the stats on your gear and shit like that.
Yep.
I'm curious about all that. We just have to see what happens.
For everybody out there worried about recovery kits, you know, the exceptional recovery kits are coming back in Update 64, but there's also every tier they put out, every tier of gear they put out, and every, you know, new set of mods that come out, like we're on tier 8 mods now, they, you know, also put out a recovery kit R&D plan that you can craft recovery kits for each tier. And you can use those to recover some of, I think it's like up to 80% of the bites you can get back. So that's just a thought for you guys out there. I don't know where Brett went. I think her internet died on her. So that's what's going to be happening with that. Now we're going to go back here and look at this post here, where they're talking about the removal of the advanced mechanics and weapon mastery bonuses. Now I know Crappy's happy about this.
Right?
I'm pretty happy about it too. I'll be completely honest with you. When I first heard about this,
I had to change my underwear twice. I read it once, made a mess. And then I changed my underwear, and I went back just to make sure I wasn't reading shit wrong, and I had to change my underwear again. I shit my pants twice. I'm shocked at that.
I'm not going to lie. When I first, you know, heard the idea of advanced mechanics being removed, I was against it. I was against it. And the only reason why I was against it was because of the 2 years that had gone in to balancing this shit. The 2 years that had gone in, 2 years of work by the devs and players to balance these powers out. The idea, the initial idea of, you know, just scrapping all of that, rubbed me the wrong way.
Hey, I'm happy. Sometimes you got to try something and you fail at it. Yeah. It just doesn't work out.
But, you know, and I thought about it more and everything like that, and I'm definitely for this. I am definitely for this.
Think of how bad it makes the community. It doesn't form players like it used to back in the day when there was more to learn and stuff was a little harder. Did I say content? How hard it is to make content for stuff like that? When everybody's just so powerful, it's hard to balance the powers like that. It's hard to give variety to the powers because AM's just locked you into such a boring place. And then, I mean, Weapon Mastery did the same thing. You did a weapon combo, you put a dot out, and you had a burst power, maybe a robot sidekick. And, like, that really dumbed down, I mean, both styles, Weapon Mastery and AM's just...
See, for me, I think the main thing with the downfall with the weapon mastery, though, was there wasn't that big of a variety with the weapons that you could use for it.
It was mainly dual wield explosive shot.
Yeah, it was either hand blasters explosive shot, or it was, you know, dual wield explosive shot. That was pretty much it. As far as like it came to like DPS and stuff.
You know, that's because for some reason they never balance out the weapons correctly. Like, I would love to use other weapon combos. Like, there's some other weapons I really like, but they're never balanced out in a way that I would like to use them. Like, I would love to use something more like a martial arts smoke bomb and melee than a one-handed flip slash. But, I mean, their balance on it is, it's just not there.
Right.
You know? It just needs to do a touch more damage. Maybe as you're doing that melee combo, since it's a longer combo, maybe you've got a bit more of CC resistance in PvE. Because you wouldn't want that in PvP, but I mean, that's why the one-handed is so good, because the one-handed does good damage, and it's a relatively quick combo, so it's forgiving. If you get knocked over, you could get back up and get the combo off quick. But if you get knocked down doing a smoke bomb from martial arts, I mean, that's a much longer combo to get back into, you know, to get your damage up there. You know, maybe if you had some resilience of getting interrupted just a little bit more, so you could actually get that longer combo off, or if the damage was there. Even if I got interrupted and then I started it back up, but at least if the damage was there, because right now the damage is decent, but it's not good enough for me to want to do that combo. And I would much rather do that combo because it just has a better range, you know, a 360 AOE. And it's just something different. You know, I don't want to use one-handed flip slash all the time. I'd like to go out and be able to use different things and still be able to do all
right. Right. Yeah. Brittany, AMs are gone, or going to be gone. How do you feel about it?
Super ecstatic about it. Super happy. Oh, people can actually use powers that they want to use, and they're not stuck into the same freaking boring rotations.
Yeah, we're going to see a lot of
I am excited.
Because Ice Melee back in the day was such a fun power to play.
Oh, it was.
And Ice today is just pressing one button. You know, and like Ice was one of, like, it was a super awesome power for Melee back in the day.
Yep.
Even range, I mean, it wasn't terrible range, but it was funner Melee. But like now, you just that one button. Mental, and how about like Mental back in the day? You wanted some single target burn on something? Bring that Mental guy in. He had some spectacular single target burn. You could also form a loadout, you know, get a little more AOE in it. But now, like, there's not a lot of strictly single target stuff in the game, and I would love things like that to come back. Like, hey, I want to put a single target burn on for this boss, or blah, blah, blah. You know, I just want some more variety. You know, I don't want to use the same thing everywhere. That's kind of boring. So it's going to be nice to have a little of that back.
Yeah. Sergio actually, you know, brings up a good point right here that my issue. They're removing the weapon mastery bonuses, which is fine. But do you guys feel that some of the combos still deserve to, like, do, you know, pretty good damage? Like, I'm always been, you know, anybody who's ever listened to this show, and I know you two have heard me say it a lot, I'm a big fan of risk versus reward when it comes to weapons and the damage that they do.
Same thing. I was just talking about that with Smoke Bomb. I definitely think the longer combos should do some good damage.
So, I mean, longer combos, slower combos, and all that, they should definitely do more damage than the quick and fast combos do, and the short combos do. I'm just hoping they take all of that into consideration when they go into looking at the weapons. And my biggest thing is melee attacks should only be hitting or doing damage within melee range.
Don't take away my range and my flip slash.
I'm sorry, sir.
We're gonna have a fight.
I'm sorry. Your mid-range flip slash needs to go, sir. All right. If it's not within 7 meters, you should not be hitting it with a melee attack.
Thing is, and I always bring this up, like, even if you're melee and point blank melee, and you really kill the distance on the melees, did that kick me out?
No, am I still here? No, you're here. Yeah. Oh, somebody else is jumping in.
Yeah.
No, this guy.
Even if, because if you cut the range on some of the melee combos, then even if you're melee and point blank, you might not be hitting everything in that pack of ads just because of the distance they are. So some things need a decent amount of distance to be able to hit, and that's why, like, some melee weapons kind of stink, because even if you're up in the stuff, you're still only hitting 2-3 ads that are in the pile just because the range on the attack stinks.
Yeah.
Like Spin Shop, for instance. Spin Shop used to be the stuff back in the day.
You were also right on top of the target when you had to do it. Same thing with Flip Slash for Dual Wield. I mean, you could start that combo up as far away as you wanted to, but when you hit that six, when you hit that hold, you were on top of the target.
I remember, though, not being able to hit everybody in the group that would spin chop. You know, and that stinks a little bit. You know, if I had a little bigger bit of an AoE on it, a little bit more range, it'd be better. Maybe. You know, because what's to say I could stand in the back with ham blasters and, you know, hit everybody and maybe be picking up more DPS just for the sole purpose of I'm hitting more people than you're hitting.
Yeah, too much one-handed talk for the stream. So we're moving on a little bit here. Also along with all this here, they are going to be adjusting the damage potential and balance overall. Damage and non-damage rolls will be brought much closer to each other in terms of damage potential, with damage still at the top of the heap, but not by 4 to 10 times like they currently are. How do you guys feel about that?
You know, I don't, like, when I'm healing, I don't really care about doing damage, you know, because most of the time I'm healing by myself and I have my hands full healing. You know, like, why do I need to do damage? That's why the DPS are there.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah, I'm the same way. I think it'll be nicer for people who don't play another role, who strictly do that one role for solos and duos so they can go in there and complete that stuff, or even alerts. I mean, you could go in with the traditional setup and pretty much everybody is DPSing, I guess, as well, and it will add for those hybrid roles that people want or have wanted
this,
to do.
I think what this has most to do with, like, with support players wanting to do more damage, it has more to deal with duos and solos.
I mean, that's why there's DPS stance, though. Yeah, I don't see why people have such a hard problem on switching over to DPS stance. And I don't get the argument where I just want to be in healer role and be able to do damage in a duo. Well, just switch to DPS. I mean, it's only a duo. Even if you don't have the best DPS gear, you could even just switch to DPS stance in your healer gear and just have a DPS loadout, and you'd be able to do just fine.
That's what I did back in the day. You just flipped roles.
Yeah.
Press up on the D-pad. Switch roles.
I don't know. I just don't get the I want to do damage and support role thing.
I gotta restart it again.
Maybe we're just too old school.
Well, you could put skill points into both roles and kind of...
Oh, you were shit if you could do that.
Yeah, that's what I did. It just made DPSing much easier. I mean, granted, you didn't have all of the powers you needed and whatever, but at least you could switch and without having to respec all your skill points.
I used to love Wolf Form because I could heal and DPS in Wolf Form. Be solo healing, healing Prime in the Wolf.
Hold on a second, guys. Don't get... I had to restart it again.
Annoying. Listen, we can't be holding up because of your internet.
Hey, listen.
this stuff just happens. Yeah. We can't rehearse it.
It's not my fault.
I'm telling you, maybe you should just try OBS. OBS is free.
Yeah, I got it on my Windows machine.
No, I think what I need to do is I need to open my freaking router back up again.
Oh, there we go. Okay. I would say I just get a... I think it takes a second. Yeah, it just takes a second for it to load. I was getting a black screen too, but it's there.
Well done, Guardian. Just finished up that mission. The DLC on Destiny is not too bad.
Nope, I still have to get my freaking Gjallarhorn.
Oh man, I miss the Gjallarhorn.
Me too.
It's better than ever too. If you're a hunter and you tether something and then hit it with a few Gjallarhorns, and then everything's all precision and the wolf pack rounds. Oof. The Gjallar tether is a fierce combo.
All right, So yeah, what we were talking, they were talking about while I was trying to get the stream back up was the days, the glory days of, you know, when having 100 skill points, you were a god, and you know, you could almost before the weapon mastery came in, you could hybrid and stuff. It was pretty cool back then.
Well, yeah, I was just saying that, like, I did do solos, but our duos back in the day in healer role, but I also switched. Like, I just pressed up on the D-pad and switched to DPS, even in my healer gear, and just DPS that way. I had a limited loadout and things like that, but I still switched. So, and I still switch in a duo. I don't do that in tank stance. I just...
Yeah.
I guess I just don't understand. Make any sense to do. Yeah. Like,
yeah.
Why be so stubborn and need to heal or tank or do something like that in a duo?
I mean, only people that would tank a duo would be Trex. You know? And that's right. I give you an opening.
You know, and there's so many tools these days with armories and everything. Like, why wouldn't you just switch? I mean, mm-hmm. you could just pick up crappy blue gear and green gear, and just, even if you're a main healer and you never DPS, you could just pick up that green and blue gear and just attune it for DPS just for those occasions. You know, like, it's blue or green gear is plenty good for duos or solos.
Make yourself a more well-rounded player just knowing how to do something more than just one role. Like, I mean, what if you're running, like, two healers and some type of content, and you end up switching, like, you lose a DPS, you could theoretically have one of the healers switch, but people are just so, no, I'm just a healer, like, that's it, okay.
I don't know how you would want to be just that role, too.
And right, why you would, I don't get it.
Like, in healing in a duo... Stop it. Just stop torturing everybody and yourself.
Even trolling. I mean, I can kind of understand the tanking portion of it just because that does serve a purpose. But healing, none of the duos are that hard that you would need somebody to be healing you for that amount of time. Or like a troller, you with AMs and everything, you pretty much power yourself if you're with a DPS. So I guess you can CC stuff, but everything would be dead.
Oh, you know what? Let me touch something on power. I think power should go back to how it was back in the day, where just the trolls feed everybody power. But maybe in smaller content, like solos, duos, and maybe just solos and duos, maybe you could just get... DC could give you a troll buff. And the troll buff could actually be worthwhile.
You realize, though, in solos and duos, every time you kill an ad or something, yeah, like that, you get those little
bubbles.
Yeah, so I mean, that's there's your troll buff.
And I guess I never had a problem, really. But I don't know, maybe just give you the tiniest little troll buff or something.
Well, what if they just like up the bubbles in those?
Yeah,
things?
Upping the bubbles would be great.
I mean, because I always thought it was weird that we had AMs and, like, well, the DPSs had AMs and stuff like that, the power back and, like, alerts and raids, because it just reduced the need for another controller. I thought for, like, solos and duos, you'd get the AM, but for anything above, like, four-player content, that power back mechanic wouldn't be there.
Yeah, it should be gone, because, you know, that's what teamwork is all about.
Yeah.
You know, there's no teamwork in it. I get all my power back myself.
Yeah, you're just self-sufficient. It doesn't really make any sense.
And the thing I never got was people back in the day were complaining, oh, power this, power that, I don't want to be a battery, blah, blah, blah. Well, instead of the devs just reducing power costs, they just kept upping power costs and upping power costs and making the situation worse, where if you just reduce the power cost a little bit or stopped upping them, I mean, it would have never been such the huge issue that it got to be.
I think the reason why they kept upping, and this is just me speculating here, I think the reason why they kept upping the power costs on everything was because they were trying to force groups to take two trolls into content instead of stacking DPS all the time. As you remember, how it was, like when docs first dropped, people were taking three trolls in there.
Oh, hell yeah. That's because we were all using phase dodge, trying to be cool. Everybody looked like they had Tourette's in the raid. It was great. Those are the funnest days ever.
So the next thing up, though, that they brought up with this is they're going to be enhancing supercharges.
Yes.
Yeah. So, you know, all those supercharge mods, everybody just like kind of chucked, you know?
Nope, I saved mine. Listen,
I went into the broker and I bought all the nature ones and all the electric ones. Do you know there was ones for nature going for $8, not even $1,000, some of the three supercharge mods. I'm like, this is how awesome nature is right now. My head mods are not even $1,000.
Well, I got super stoked for my new fire tune I've been leveling up because I've got like a Eternal Flame 3 supercharge mod for her. And I'm like, oh my God. And I got a Fireball Barrage too. And I'm like, oh my, this is going to be awesome. This is gonna be awesome. I hope nature's
carnivorous plants is good because that's a cool supercharge, but it was just always doo doo.
But I mean,
like all of them.
I mean, if this is exactly what we think it is, you know, where they say here, it's gonna replace the AM burst that we've been used to with the AMs and everything. If these supercharges are gonna be like that, I'm really looking forward to these supercharges like doing like hell of a lot of damage now.
Listen, yeah. Nature's going to be OP. Like, I shouldn't say that, but I mean, I have some tricks up my sleeve.
There's some damage supercharges for Atomic that I'm just like, man, I would love to see. I cannot wait to see this murder ads. And especially like with fire too. I cannot wait to see Volcanic Calamity just melt stuff, I'm sure Brittany's looking forward to using Berserk again.
Oh, yeah. So I can Berserk get countered and then it'll be done. Like, I can't wait.
Right.
Maybe my one hit will actually give me, 100k damage. I don't know. I doubt that. But, ugh. Poor Zerk.
You got to pop an immunity in Berserk at the same time. it would be cool if Berserk gave you some immunity.
Like, yeah.
When we were doing the update, man, I was asking Tunzo left and right. I was like, hey, can we get an update to Berserk so it works from all ranges and just have it scale? Because, when you're Rage, your range loadout is pretty empty. You just throw some stuff in there to fill it up, kind of, in a way. And if you could put Berserk in there, because Infuriate is a doo-doo supercharge, let's be honest. That shit sucks.
Well, it buffs everybody else. I don't want to buff everyone else. I just want my own supercharge.
I don't mind that. But
why
what
don't
if
you want to buff everybody else, though, Britt?
Because I'm not here to help them.
But it's a team effort. It's a team effort.
No, it's not.
You're trying to get to the top of the scoreboard. Is that what you're doing?
I'm never getting the top of the scoreboard.
Listen, you never know.
I might make a comeback. Maybe in a few months,
but I mean, but other supercharges too, like electricity's supercharged Trex. I can hear myself through your mic, so fix that before you chime in again, please, sir. Trex has been lurking in his chat, stalking Brittany for the past 20 minutes.
At least he's not singing this week with his mic now muted.
He's every once in a while unmute his mic to try and chime in something. I've caught him a couple of times. See, I haven't heard anything he said yet, but now I understand why. It's because he doesn't have his mic set up right. But other superchargers, like electricity's got some supercharges that do have some like pretty fantastic animations, like Megavolt and all that. But they've never really been there. As far as damage potential, I remember, and I know you two remember as well. Some of these supercharges used to be like godly. You know, you get somebody with so many super, these superchargers. I mean, I remember going to FOS, you know, 8v8, you know, and popping a Volcanic Calamity down on a huge group of freaking, you know, people in PvP and watching them just scatter. You know what I mean? They were like running like they were literally on fire, slapping their heads, you know, trying to put the flames out and everything.
Like supers were super.
Yeah. So I'm really looking forward to this. I'm looking forward to seeing superchargers being incorporated into loadouts again. This is going to be fantastic.
Yeah.
And I hope they all do good damage. I hope there's not this one super that is really awesome. And then, you know, like, I don't want it to be like that. I hope they all do roughly the same damage, you know, because the powers are never going to be perfect. But at least if the supers, they could kind of get them all on par, it would be nice.
Yeah, it'll just have more variation. I mean, so you don't get those same cookie cutter loadouts again. It's just
so everybody doesn't flock to this power because this supercharge is super OP and this one isn't. You know, I don't want that to be happening.
And then of course they're talking about modifying power and power regeneration. Now we talked about how the
weapon mastery. I got power regeneration.
The weapon mastery. Control. One thing that we've talked about is weapon mastery crit bonuses and the power reduction is being removed, but the weapon mastery combos are still going to be there. So for certain, you know, support roles like healing and controlling, it's still going to be beneficial for you to use that brawling shuriken combo because it still has the lowest. Unless they change it. it has the lowest counter for star power regen. But this is going to be interesting to see. I mean, what do you hope they do? I mean, with you know, AMs being completely gone now, obviously, you know, Brittany mentioned earlier about, you know, us using two trolls again. But power regen for, you know, instances like, you know, you're in a duo or you're in a solo. What are you hoping for that they do with that outside of just, you know, giving us the blue baubles once we, you know, kill ads or something? That was a question.
Oh. I don't know. Like, I'm trying to think of, like, what did we do before?
We had a troll.
Well, no, in a duo. Like, back in the day, like...
We just learned, I guess, because everybody used weapons. We
yeah, I was gonna say, I don't...
our powers, so like, I mean, we just learned to, you know, manage. Hell, if you ran out of power in a duo, whatever, you know what I mean? You just use weapon attacks just, and you toughed it out. You were like, shit, I have no power. But let me drink a soda. You know, I remember those days, like my buddy Rock was fire, and he'd be using fire burst, and he'd run out of power pretty quick. In like an alert or a duo if we didn't have a troll, but whatever, we sucked it up and started to use weapons because powers weren't super OP, you know what I mean? Your weapons were still on par to an extent. People are gonna shit if they have to regen their own power though.
Well, I mean, like
if the healer has to help out and do weapon combos now, you can't just stand in the back,
yeah,
let the troll feed them.
Can't just stay in the back and let the other DPS take all the damage?
And be the nature healer? I'm so happy about the bug. My thing with the bug was, man, all these people were like, oh, you have to use bug, you have to use bug. Bro, I healed since the beginning of fucking time with the bug, or I mean with nature, and I never used the bug. What about all us old school people who always healed stuff in human form?
Yeah.
Never had an issue with power.
Yeah, I did both. Because yeah, I hate bug form. I hate the look of it. I hate everything the bug form is. So this is going to be awesome.
Me too. I hate the movement.
Mm-hmm. You know,
I feel I like healing in bug now is even better, or in human is even better than it was back in the day. Because now you could just hit harvest, where back in the day, harvest wasn't such a good thing.
Yeah.
Because it overrid metabolism.
Yep.
You know, but now, I mean, you could save a little bit more power by using it. You know, so it's a little bit easier. People just don't know how to pace themselves. You know, everyone's right off the bat hitting Blossom. you know, clearing all their pheromones and their restack and everything, and they're out of power real quick. You know, it's not a power issue, it's just because people don't understand the power and how it works. You know, I mean, if I was able to heal stuff in wolf form back in the day, you know, I don't think there was a problem with power in nature healing.
Yeah. There really wasn't. I mean, even before AMs, you know, before AMs, nature was considered one of the better healing powers.
I always liked nature because you could heal everybody in the group all the time.
Yeah, and another thing, too, before AMs, electricity was considered, you know, a pretty decent healing power, too. Right now, electricity, I mean, I've tried healing with electricity, and it's just so freaking hard right now. It's power costly.
It's a pain. It's doable, but it's a pain in the ass.
It's, you know, and it. I'm not seeing the same, you know, heals and everything that I was doing before they brought AMs into it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it seems like bioelectric surge isn't as big of a heal as it used to be. Maybe because
BioCap isn't, you know, working the way it was before.
BioCap is such a small heal now. I don't remember it being that small. Like when you hit somebody with BioCap, it's a really small heal.
Yeah.
I didn't really heal a lot with it back in the day, but like I don't remember it being that small. Like BioCap barely heals people.
Like, I didn't really ever have issues. Like I healed a lot of things with ELEC, and it was never I don't think it was ever a burden or ever felt that like I couldn't heal anything. And now, like I switched one of my alts to ELAC a few months ago, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, this is awful. What? I don't ever remember it being like this ever. Well, no, it was fun to heal with ELAC, and you always got like these really big crits, and that was the big thing is you could just burst people really well with ELAC, and it's
not
just
like that now.
It's very difficult to heal with ELEC now, and I don't really know why it is.
I think when everybody got such a higher health pool or something, like, for some reason I feel like bioelectric surge never scaled up a lot, because sometimes you have to hit people 2-3 times to full health them. And that's crazy, because then, I mean, you're out of power lickety-split if you're trying to full health people. Like, what happened to... I used to just be able to bioelectric surge, and bam, you were pretty much right at the top.
Yeah, you used to be able to
build up.
You know, jump into a group that was like low on damage from an AOE and freaking pop galvanize, and bam, their health was like filled.
One thing I'd like to see BioCap, everybody in the group on one cast instead of me having to run around and look at everybody and see if they're BioCap, because then you could bioelectric surge and heal everybody in the group. And it would just be, it'd be a lot easier.
Yeah, grid.
You know, it'd be more efficient.
Grid, he electric heals all the time, and he, you know, he's in here saying it's like the scaling was off.
Yeah.
As CR got higher.
Me running around the room making sure everybody's bio-capped is a pain. I don't want to pay attention to what you got going on, because sometimes I'm fearing for my life because shit is trying to kill me.
I switched. You know how much of a fan I am of the flight movement mode, as much as, you know, it seems like the game's got everything against it. I switched my electric tune to freaking super speed just because I needed to be able to get around faster.
Man,
you know, I'm super speed on my electric guy. It goes with it.
So yeah, it's definitely a pain. It's definitely a pain. Hopefully,
and the power cost needs to be reduced on electric, big time. Because I feel when I electric heal, I'm really not pushing a lot of buttons, but my power goes right out the window.
Yeah.
Like, I don't try to full health everybody because of the way electricity is, you know? Because if you're trying to top everybody off every second, you're never going to have any power. You know? And, like, it's just crazy the amount of power you use.
Well, also, too, I mean, you definitely need to make sure you get your HOTS out on everybody before the freaking boss fight starts. It's not like nature, you know.
Electricity is HOTS.
Tank can jump. Well, yeah. You know what I'm saying. But, I mean, a tank can jump in, and nature is like, oh, real quick, here, Savage, you know, Harvest, you know, okay, all right, my HOTS are out. Everybody's getting healed up, you know. And then, but with electric, you're like, okay, I got BioCap here. Okay, now, these guys don't have it. BioCap again. All right, throw out galvanized on, get that hot on them. You know, it's like, oh my god,
such a pain. I don't even use galvanized a lot because it's just something else that wastes my power.
Yeah. Most people use E-Burst more, actually.
Yeah.
E-Burst is pretty OP.
Yeah, it's really good, especially in small stuff. Mm-hmm. Alerts. I use a lot of Arc Lightning. I do like a Webmaster combo, Arc Lightning, yeah, like every two Webmaster combos. Like,
that was like the go-to heal for the tanks, man. That was like the go-to heal for the tanks, and now it hardly does it. I mean, it's that's another power that doesn't really heal that well anymore. Anyways, that's enough electric before the stream crashes.
Make electric so, again.
Right. So,
the next thing they're talking about doing here is they are removing power points. How excited were you guys about that?
I'm really excited about having all the powers I want, because now I could try loadouts that I always wanted to try, but I never had.
You didn't have enough power points.
Oh, we don't have to go respec.
Yeah. How finally. Here's with like electricity, look. You could use static push, and you're not stuck with shockwave because now you have those power points. It's gonna be a good day.
By removing power points, it doesn't mean that once you get off the ship, you're gonna have access to every power in your tree, in both your trees. They've taken both the power trees, they put them into one tree. So like with electricity here, they showed it's just electricity right now. You unlock a power every level. A power or two every level. This is a work in progress right here, because I know Ionic Drain's listed twice when you hit level 27. But by the time you hit level 30, though, every single power that is in your current power trees, or every power that you have available to you is going to be unlocked. So basically, when you go to do your loadout, it's going to look like this. You're gonna have every single power that you spec into, or that you could possibly have, you can throw into your loadout. Now, that doesn't mean that any power you throw in your loadout is gonna make for a good loadout. Not by a long run.
That's exactly what it means. Exactly what it means.
You maybe
you
trucks.
Can have anything you want to, because you are special.
Oh God.
Yeah.
Trex is back, everybody.
I'm super excited.
What I'm really excited for is to see, because DCO Blowguide, one of the, honestly, the number one place to look at all your talents and all your good stuff. Those talent or skill calculators are done. They are finito. And I'm really happy because I looked at my program that I worked on. I'm like, you mean nothing now. You're useless. It's gonna. That's right. Clown Box and the Ragebringer. That's what's gonna happen.
But Iconics are different though, because you don't get the Iconics. Iconics are not included in this, folks. For the Iconics, you're going to have to use skill points to get those Iconics.
And Trex, I'm just going to borrow Brittany's skill points.
And Trex, yeah, you don't have the skill points to spare, sir. You don't have the skill
have
points
plenty.
To spare. You have, like, what, 130?
Something, yeah.
Yeah, something. You don't even know anymore. It's been that long.
It has been a rough summer, sir, okay? A rough summer.
But yeah, all the iconic powers, excluding the innate powers, are going to, into an their own iconic powers tree, where you have to go into and use skill points in order to get them. Only cost one skill point, but for everybody out there who likes to use Lasso, or Word of Power, or any of the other iconics that are useless compared to those two. You can use a skill point to get those. What's that?
Who did all these screenshots for the stream?
I did.
Oh, that's really nice. Good touch.
Thank you. I was on the ball today.
No kidding. You had to. You had 3 days.
But, yeah, so, yeah, if you guys want the iconics and all that, you know, you'll have to go in and use a skill point to pick those up. Now, of course, the as you can see right here, where they had the traits window opened up, you can see that, you know, you've got your electricity, your iconic powers, your stat points, which we've shown, your flight, which is your or your movement. Then Batside says 138 skill points is better than 137 skill points, Trek. So
that's you know what?
Apparently he is in game and just checked the league roster and saw.
You know what? 138 becomes too overpowered, and you know I like to be one with the people. Yeah. So that 137 is a good medium because I don't want to overshadow my fellow players.
Yeah,
you, and you know, like be hot stuff. Like, you know, 137, I'm equal with the middle class. I don't need to be
There's a difference between being one of the people and being one of those people. All right.
Whoa! What do you mean, those people?
You're about to become one of those people that everybody talks about when it comes to, you know, not being able to do content because they ain't got the skill points to do it.
But hey, at least I'm being talked about. Am I right? Am I right? Self high five.
Oh man! But so yeah, the traits trees right here. You see electricity, iconic powers, stat points, which we've shown, your movement mode, and then you go down into the weapons and the loadout. The weapons trees look extremely different now. In case you guys don't remember seeing those, there's no stat buffs in them whatsoever.
Yay!
Pretty. So pretty.
So basically now, you can still spec into the Weapon Masteries. You can see the Weapon Mastery combos are down here below. In order to get those Weapon Mastery combos, you need to have all the combos. I believe you're going to need to have all the combos or spec into all the combos for each of those weapons. So you're looking at, I guess it's that's 8 right there. Eight, at least around 8 skill points per weapon.
What are weapons? I'm ice.
Oh, you're going to find out, sirs. Those poor ice guys, man. I know one ice player, though, man, who is, like, really super excited for this because he used to ice DPS before the AM came out for it, and he loved ice DPSing with hand blasters. Absolutely loved it. You know it, Sledge.
I mean, I just want to spam powers. I don't want to have to use weapon attacks. What the hell?
That's right, Grid. Every single player is going to have to respec everything.
Yeah, I know. I'm sitting here looking. I'm like, I've got 4 armories and 3 lairs and 3 and another one, and I'm like, oh no!
But it'll be so worth it.
Oh, it's gonna be so worth it. Yeah, it's gonna be so worth it. But we were talking earlier, Britt, when you had your computer issue. This right here, this is gonna make things interesting right here. The stat points, because I mean, how much health do you pick up, you know, as a earth tank? You know, how much vit do you,
who cares?
How much dominance do you ignore as a controller?
Well, that'll be the fun thing. Like, that's what I'm actually really looking forward to, is messing around with how you spec your skill points to see what is the most optimal build.
Right.
Or allotment, I guess. So I think that's going to be super fun.
Hold on.
Yeah, that's definitely going to be cool.
Yeah.
You're still there? It just buffered for a sec. It's still there.
I got the circle too. I got scared.
Oh, no.
Grit says no. He's not. Nobody's
there. He doesn't? Oh.
Oh, no.
He might have to refresh because I can still hear us.
Yeah, we're good. I just refreshed.
Yeah, I can still hear it.
All right, Bat Side says we're back, so I trust Bat Side. And Grid's got a commercial. So I'm not the only one. Yeah, get ad block, Grid.
I know. Come on.
Yell at him.
Get this ad block.
Wait, actually, but if you're on a mobile device, just switch to chat only and then switch back to audio or like video and you'll completely bypass the commercial.
Oh.
Somebody showed me that. So if you're on a mobile or
that's a good trick.
Tablet, do that and you don't have to watch commercials. It's awesome.
Where are you going?
You know, as streamers, we want the commercials, right? You know this. We
earmuffs, I guess.
So
no, AdBlock is not a thing. What is wrong with you?
Here, I'll link you. Hold on one sec. I'll send it to you in a whisper.
AdBlock Plus though is now making money off of ads. Just remember that.
Yeah, part. I saw that.
That is some Starbucks across a Starbucks mess right there.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, this is like, you know, this is going to be really interesting to see how exactly, you know, you put your skill points into stuff and all that. I mean, do you completely ignore dominance as a controller? Do you just go, for your pure vit, you know, or do you in those, I was talking to Crappy about this, earlier, Brett, do you, with your two-troller setup, going into a raid, do you have one troll who is there for, you know, the POT, he's there for, you know, dumping power, you have the other troller who is there for all the CCs and the debuffs, and he can do it because his dominance is so high. Remember with Throne?
Mm-hmm.
You had to, remember when Throne first dropped, people, you know, trollers had to drink a dominance soda? In order to have enough Dom to CC any of the ads in there,
yeah.
And Love and War with the what was that damn Pink Lantern? The one that
the drank. Vexer,
yes. Having to CC the Vexer, you know, keep the Vexer CC'd. I know. I don't think anybody had to drink a Dom soda for that, but you know, you had to have a troll, a troller over there to make sure that. You know, that Vexer was CC'd, so she wasn't going around freaking, you know, drain everybody of the power and stuff. So, this is going to be cool.
That was,
you know,
when you've got,
this is going to be really cool, man. Two troll runs, everybody out there who does not remember or was not playing at the time, you guys have no idea how smooth and fun two troll runs are in raids.
You let me have two tanks and then come talk to me.
You really, really seriously do not understand how smooth and fun those runs are. When you've got a controller who is like keeping the ad CC'd and everything, like if an ad is off in the distance and the tank can't get to it yet and all that, you've got an extra troller to go over there and freaking CC that ad. You guys do not know what you're missing with this stuff.
I just like it because I feel like it's more teamwork.
Yeah, so that was back in the day when you actually needed to talk to your other players and, like, you need to talk to your troll buddy and figure out who's doing what, and I don't know. I enjoyed that.
I don't see any crowd control in this game unless it comes from a tank just literally juggling enemies.
Well, that's because you only see that one controller in there.
So what are you talking about, the DP?
And a lot of the controllers that we have today do not understand what crowd control is.
I know what crowd control is, and even back in the day, there was no crowd control. The only thing I have seen controllers do is just debuff the boss and give me power. That's all I need from you.
That's because tanks do such a good job on their own.
Yeah.
CCing stuff. But at the same time, I don't think a lot of trollers know when the appropriate time to CC things.
Yeah, you don't CC them before.
Yeah.
You don't CC them before the tank pulls them in on top of them. You definitely don't do that.
Trust me. I know crowd control because I am a tank. I have
You do. I'm just saying the average Joe. Average controller.
Yeah. I mean, even back in the day, it's like okay. I mean, you have the controller. It's like, all right, controller, that guy over there, keep him stunned. Well, Wait, he was supposed to be stunned. What happened? DPS hit him. Oh, mother!
I like my
at that point, it's like, why even bother?
Scattered all over the room.
Oh, and by crowd control, and controllers out there, by crowd control, we mean stuns that keep them in one spot. We do not mean things that you entrap them in and they end up bouncing all over God's heaven.
That's so much fun sometimes.
Do not, I know. My God, that pisses me off so bad.
Stasis.
Not run in casements. Do not run in casements. Oh, we had a guy in the league. He came back from being gone for a while. He was mental, and the dude was freaking running Thought Bubble, dude. And I was like, stop it. I was like, stop it. You need to stop that right now. And he's like, what? I was like, you need to stop running that. And he's like, I've always run this. I was like, yeah, but you need to stop it now. I was like, the ads are all over the freaking place. Knock it off.
Check the stream.
Yeah, it just freaking died. God damn. Dude, seriously, this is expert, man.
With chronometric emitters so they could run in front of the tank?
I don't know.
Love that. I was like, well, if you're just going to tank this yourself, I'm out.
Listen, when we're in a group and radio's tanking and the DPS do that, he just stands there and lets them die. And it's fucking hilarious.
I've done that with pugs before, too.
He's just like, oh, really? You're going in front of me? I guess you got this whole group of ads by yourself, then.
And you might, I mean, I remember my streams crashing, too. And that, I mean, it literally was because just the servers were just sucking.
Yeah, it's freaking... It's not me. It's not even Twitch, surprisingly. So the way folks are going to be speccing is going to be really freaking interesting. I'm looking forward to trying to figure out what's the best way to spec for each role.
You best believe I'll be getting my loadout videos done. I'll be back.
You could make loadout videos again. How about that?
Yeah, how's about that?
Yeah.
Screw
you, cookie cutters.
Actually, Srone, you cannot blame me. Maggie jinxed me at the beginning before I even started the show. Made a comment hoping my internet would be okay for tonight, and completely jinxed me. It's all her fault.
All her fault.
If you see her on game, it's XXX Maggie XXX. Send her a tell and say, send her a tell saying, SP said it's your fault.
Damn, I don't know if you should have put her on blast like that.
Why don't you give out her address too while you're at it?
On Twitter, not
it's
in the
no,
game.
It's no worse than that one time when freaking I told everybody to send new a tell that I wasn't looking to be his new dad. I was just wanting to be his friend.
I sent those. I'm guilty.
I logged on to the game and he cussed me out so bad. It was funny. let's go back here to the forum post. We're still going down here into the final thing. Ending mid-range.
Boo. Boo when you touch a burger. Boo.
Listen, I don't want to be the guy who says this, but like I'm not the only one. But I remember when they started this whole weapon mastery junk, and me and a couple other people, we were all like, hey, this is a really bad idea.
All right,
and
then
it just spiraled out of control, and I don't want to be that guy, but like I told you so.
Hold on, let me get my DCUO kiss-ass hat on real fast.
Here we go.
So... Because I've seen the posts on the forums in this thread, and which, like, this morning I woke up, it was 57 pages. I'm like, guess what? I'm not going to be reading. But I saw,
right?
I was at page 12. I missed an entire day, and I wasn't going to have any of this. I didn't want to read all this, so I skimmed as much as I could. But, and people were, of course, saying, it's like, oh, well, here's 3 years down the drain. We wasted our time here. No, you didn't. Welcome to MMOs. I've said it before and I've said it again. Welcome to MMOs. This isn't Call of Duty. It's not the same goddamn game every single year. You can put zombies in it. It's still the damn same game. I don't care. MMOs are about evolution. True, some evolutions are a de-evolution. And you know what? It's a whole point of taking risk and trying things out. Don't buffer on me, you damn stream. Don't you dare buffer.
It's not buffered for me, so that's to you.
Okay.
Oh, wait. It just said I'm online. Offline.
Oh, groovy.
Why is it saying I'm offline?
Just when Trex is getting to his point.
I know.
Damn it. Maybe he has to get to the point faster.
Apparently. I got 10 seconds. Okay. So, quickly, my point. It's an MMO. Welcome to it. There's going to be trial. There's going to be error. The game is going to be changed dramatically, and it's going to last for maybe a year or two. It just happens. That's the way it goes. As players, we just have to adapt and evolve with the game. That's what we just have to do. True. Advanced mechanics and weapon mastery. Did we like it? Sure. Did we hate it? Sure. Is it going to go away now? Sure. Do we care? You shouldn't, because now we're going to go into something new. I can tell you now, I've been playing World of Warcraft for close to 10 years. Well, I'll give it this, 5 years. I have seen this game. I have seen that game change multiple times. Have I liked it? Yes. Have I hated it? Yes. Do I go along with the flow? But of course I do. It's about evolution. This isn't the same. It's never going to be the same game over and over. They're going to make tweaks that is going to try and better the community. If it doesn't, then they will look back and see what they can change to make it better. If they go back to everything here, yes. Will they change something in the future? Yes. This is what you have to do. Everyone bitching about the combat mechanics being changed again, suck it up, deal with it, or go play Call of Duty with your mom. And I'm done.
With your mom? Or my
I don't
mom?
Think my mom plays Call of Duty. In
their mom. Their mom. My mom's too cool for games, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Always too cool for games.
Now, with the removal of the mid-range, they are taking into account the fact that a lot of people out there use melee or damage over time abilities. They recognize that the concern is valid, so they will continue the standardization effort, working to more consistently define abilities as melee up to 7 meters or range greater than 7 meters, and adjusting damage to suit. Now, I believe I believe weapons are going to fall in with this. That's why I was going back to saying how weapon attacks should only do damage within melee weapon attacks should only do damage within 7 meters. I believe it's going to fall in with that. But what they're talking about doing is they are making sure that they're going to address the concerns of folks out there who are, say, rage DPS, Brittany. Not so much Trax. But I know you are.
Yes, I know how to go pew pew. I mean blah blah.
But yeah, for especially powers like rage, that is purely a melee DPS. I mean, it's only got like one ranged power that does damage, or you know, significant damage, I should say. But also powers like Hardlight, there's a very doable loadout that you can use for meleeing with Hardlight. So, you know, other powers like that. I was joking around earlier today about coming up with a purely precision build loadout for Atomic and going full melee with it.
I'm not going to have you in my group.
But, dude, if I go, like, full precision with it, man, plus, you know, I use the aura, and on top of that, you know, I've got, you know, some, you know, extra skill points thrown in there for some toughness and for extra health, you know, it should be good to go. Should be good to go. My thing with this is, all right, I understand that, you know, there are still powers and there's still going to be people that are going to want to melee DPS. But the fact that, you know, damage 7 meters out is going to be the same no matter how close you are or how far away you are. Like, mass dead at 8 meters is still going to hit the same amount of damage it would at maximum range. For me, as a tank, this is awesome.
You know, for me as a DPS, that's awesome too, because yeah. I hate to be pressured to do the best damage and stand closer, like to do the best mm-hmm. damage, because I like to live. And like a lot of the times, I don't care if I'm not top DPS because I don't like to die over and over and risk being close. I mean, a lot of times you can play it safe and be perfectly fine, but it just sucks to be put in that situation where you're pressured to stand closer. I think that was a really bad thing that they did with that.
Well, and it sucked because melee powers that were truly melee pretty much got shafted by powers that weren't melee. That could still do the same amount of damage that, like, at a safer range.
Yeah.
Well, you could be at the 7 meter mark, whereas if I want to melee with rage, I have to be on top of the boss. So you're still technically in a safer range than I am.
Yeah.
And you're doing, like, 30-40% more damage than I am, and there's literally no reward for me putting myself at risk and then DPSing. Like, it just doesn't make any sense at all. And so that's why I hated this mid-range stuff. Because of that. Like, it just
all those people who didn't truly melee should have never got melee damage. The ice guy, gadgets, all those guys just standing close should have never got melee damage. Because how are you going to balance that, like you said, with powers like Rage and Light who are actually meleeing?
Yeah. Shrun brings up a good point, too. If you are saying... I know he's you know, rage and everything, but I mean, he brings up a good point about tanking. If you're a DPS and you're still DPSing in my back pocket and you die, I am not going to have any issue whatsoever tanking the boss on top of your dead body, and I will drop a supply drop on top of it just to add injury to insult because you can't get picked up. I'm not going
to
care.
How hard is it for DPS to stand behind a boss? How hard?
All right. Well, it's not just that. There's AOE attacks.
Perfect example. Last night, had a few pugs in there. Keeb was with us last night, correct? We had a few pugs in there with us doing DWF. We had Mantis and Caleb back. Couple of easy bosses. No big deal, right? You would think. We had two pug ice DPS. Both of them kept dying all the time. Why? Because one, they wouldn't get out of the way when Mantis would, you know, bounce over and do his one shot. One time, Mantis actually stayed on me to do his one shot, and the ice DPS stayed right next to me and died from the AoE. Right? Which it always started a cascade effect, because DPS would die, Bat Side would come over to pick him up, Bat Side would die, nobody was able to pick up Bat Side, we don't have a troller anymore, oh, guess what, everybody's out of power, we're all wiped out.
Well, it sounds to me that DPS, the melee DPS, need to know about the boss mechanics. They need to learn how to go to get out of the fight and then go back in.
Oh, yeah.
It's a learning process. It's really sad that melee DPS really cannot understand or learn that sometimes you just can't be in there, and you don't have to be number one DPS. There's no point. It's like, as long as the boss dies, you did your job. Yeah. And you did your job well,
Halo. But the scoreboard's broken, and everybody needs to be on top. So,
well, I'm number one, crappy. So suck it. Rage DPS for the win.
This guy.
Rage melee DPS for the win. Suck it, sorcery.
6 per second. But with all of this moving forward and everything, they are definitely making sure that things, you know, it's going to be a constant adjustment and tweaks and fixes and balances are going to be done continuously throughout the this process and moving forward and everything there. So when this stuff hits test, I know I'm going to get on. I'm going to at least test out one or two powers and see where they're at. Crap. Stream just died again.
No, it didn't. It's back.
Didn't?
I'm on commercial.
Oh, all right.
It's nice to see him team solo mid for a Geico commercial. It's actually weird.
But, so the balance effort is going to be going forward. You know, from the day this drops on the test server up until the day the game finally goes bye-bye. I mean, balancing is something that's... There's nothing's ever going to be perfect. If there's one thing anybody, I mean, the four of us, I'm sure, have learned with this game in the past 5 years, nothing is ever perfect.
Rage is perfect. What's he talking about, guys?
Listen, I will say, though, right before game update 36 drop, a lot of the powers are really close. Except, like, was it Earth and... What was it? Earth and another one? Earth and Electric maybe were a little poopy, but they were still okay, and we could touch those two powers up and been all right.
Well, Electric, I would say the thing that made it a little not as great was, I think Voltaic Bolt got nerfed a little bit too much. And with Earth, I'm not sure exactly. I don't think enough people were actually using the pet mechanic with Earth at the time. It was the issue with Earth.
It wasn't a really pet mechanic, though.
Yeah.
Hey, but you can make any power good if you put phase dodge on it. You know, like... Phase dodge. Like, my power's a little shitty. It's like phase dodge on this.
That's because you're ice. Don't worry, you'll change. It'll be better for you.
So, who do you guys think is coming back to the game that's quit? Go ahead. Other than Trex, this is the news source cast. I don't care if you drop names.
Oh, that's right. It's not where I got the host and I tried to play, you know, equal to everyone and try to be respectful to everyone. Hey. No, Cole Fusion's dumbass will probably come back.
Of course he will.
Like, I have no idea... Why? Because here's the thing, I'm not even gonna say I quit because I still log in because I still pay a subscription. I'm taking a break because I really needed that break and I had other things to go on. Sure enough, Amazon Fury Part 3, I am back full force. Stats Matter, I am back doing videos slowly. I don't understand the point of having to make a video or go on the forums like, all right, guys, I'm taking off. I don't have anything useful to do anymore. I don't know. But no, just stop making the go away videos and just go away.
I feel where he's coming from, though. I've been in those shoes.
I have too.
But there's a difference between making 5 or 6 going away videos and coming back every single time and then trying to shit on every single person who plays the game and then relive your glory days that were 5 years ago and then... be so high up on your high horse and thinking that everybody knows who you are when, number one, nobody does, and number two, nobody cares. So there's a big difference there. But, you know, that's just me.
I'll sit here and I'll say this, and this is me kind of being the devil's advocate here with his last I Quit video. I understood a lot where he was coming from. I really did. Granted, I agree with Brittany, and I mean, there's only so many times you can quit before, you know, people are just going to like roll their eyes at you. I understood where he was coming from with a lot of it. I definitely understand his frustrations. I mean, you know, we've all felt those same frustrations. Maybe not as great as him or anything like that, but at the same time, you know, I sat there and I listened to some of the things he said about, you know, his glory days and, you know, he left his mark on the game, you know, with his league and all that, having that epic Odyssey feat named after them and everything. And all I could sit there and think was, you know, before they closed the portal up, I could walk in and solo that feat.
Well, now.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, but because that portal's closed... Now, if you want to run docks to get some gear to salvage and everything, you know, you got to queue up for it. So now, pretty much everybody's going to have that feat. You know what I'm saying?
Not this guy.
So it's not that spectacular, you know, of a thing to do. I mean, leaving your mark on the game isn't just, you know, having, you know, a feat named after your league or anything. Leaving your mark on the game is, you know, being... involved with the community and with you know, not sitting back sniping at the community, but being involved with the community, talking to the players, talking to the devs, and pushing for, you know, the changes that, you know, we've seen are coming with this update. I mean, there's a lot of people out there saying get rid of AMs, get rid of weapon mastery, and they're doing it.
But you're trying to make the game better, not mm-hmm. He is the epitome of what is wrong with this community. Like, he is that. He is what's wrong with this community. And as much as he wanted to make himself over, like, oh, I'm gonna make videos for people, he showed his true colors yet again by making that stupid video he did. I don't even know what it was, but I didn't spend my time watching it because he's just a waste of time. Like, there's nothing about him that will ever be good and that will want to actually make this game and the community better. Nothing. So I just think he's a big joke. Like, he's just whatever to me, but he's not here to do anything good for the game at all. He just wants people to know who he is, and so he can sit here and say that he was once a part of something good, and he's no longer a part of that anymore. So,
yeah, well, I mean, in that respect, I do completely agree with you. He kind of falls in with that group of players who, they've got their own agenda.
Yeah.
They've got their own agenda of getting things fixed and or changed to suit the way they want to play the game, not the way the community wants to play the game.
I have my own agenda. Let's make your nature great again.
Your agenda is make nature great again, which obviously which is something that the community is behind, though, Crappy. It's not just you. You know, it's not just you or like five or six other guys, you know, like these, you know, these.
I just want to play nature and I want everybody else's power to get shit on. But if I have to take everybody down to make me good, so be it.
But I mean, I'll lump him in with the same, you know, group, like with the guys that are outspoken about PvP on the forums. You know, they've got their own agenda. You know, they're only out to get things changed the way they want to play the game, not the way the community wants to play the game. And you know, it's not knocking their knowledge in any way, shape, or form. It's just, you know, they have very selfish motives when it comes to that stuff like that. So yeah, I do agree with you on that, Britt. But you know, I mean, you want to really leave your mark on the game, you know, do what I'm trying to do. You know, I'm trying to get my tune to replace the Superman statue in Centennial Park.
That is the way to do it, folks.
That's leaving your mark on the game, folks.
Don't worry, I'm still trying to get an NPC named after me. It'll happen.
You already got a conference room named after you.
Yeah, but I need something in the game.
And your own parking spot.
Nobody else is going to know about that.
You have, through booster bundles, you have a conference room and you bought Spittle's old parking spot at the Austin.
I mean, until they name one of the booster bundles after me, I need to go for
She's not wrong.
You're gonna take it away from Booster Gold. It's gonna be the Brittany Booster Bundle.
Pretty much. Trophies.
I mean, I wouldn't mind a definitely an NPC named after me.
See, I was trying to get T Lantern to do it, but he doesn't know who I am.
I mean, can we change all the sparring targets' name to my name? That would be. I'll be okay with that. I would definitely be. I mean, that's basically my life in a nutshell. I tell you what.
But then they have to miraculously like rage crash or something. I don't know. They need some type of mechanic like that where they just fall over.
That's true.
You guys got anything else you guys want to add though about the update?
When is it coming to test?
I don't know.
When is it coming to
Hopefully soon. Well, update 64 is still on test. We don't know when exactly that's dropping, but it should be, you know, trademarked soon. With October just coming up next week, I believe.
I want to play survival mode with these changes. That's what I want to do. I want to be able to play survival mode as nature DPS.
See, that's going to be interesting. If survival mode's still around when these changes come to live, that's going to be a game changer for survival mode too. Because how many people do you think are actually going to be able to make it to round 10? Much less make it to round 20 of Owen.
I can do it.
No, you can't.
I will try. Damn it. But I think that with this update, it's another game changer that the game really needs. And I mean, I am definitely all for. I'm all for it. I mean, even someone who has low skill points, like, it doesn't matter to me. It will still bring it back to where I feel powerful compared to the combat rating determining everything for me. And which is exactly how it should be. The combat rating should only tell you what content you need to get into. That's all it needs to do. Everything else needs to follow along with your character and your skill points. So I'm really interested to really... I feel like I need to find some Xbox YouTubers if that's a thing. And I want to talk to them about this change, because the Xbox community is the brand new community this year. This is all they have. They may or may not know about advanced mechanics. This stats matter thing, the PlayStation and PC, we know what's coming. We know what's coming. Xbox, they, in their eyes, this could be the end of the world for them, because they just don't know. So I really want to talk to those guys.
They don't have to worry.
It could be the end of the world.
It could be rough for them. It could be rough for them.
It could.
I don't think it will be. Players.
I mean, it's not going to be that bad, because there are people out there who, you know, have been doing this for a while. You know, and like, you know, Trek's going to be coming back doing some loadout videos. I'm going to get back into doing loadout videos, because they're going to need to be done. You know, crappy, you're going to have to start doing them too.
Yeah.
I'm not helping anybody. I'm all for myself.
Just like
I have some plans with these supercharges, and
he ain't gonna tell no one. It's only him.
I got some things started up.
I got some things. I got them.
Now I'll be putting out some helpful videos, especially for, you know, the newer Xbox players and stuff like that, because a lot of those people have no clue how it was back in the day.
They don't.
Oh, how amazing it was back in the day.
Yeah.
How much fun it was to actually DPS.
Yeah.
Right? It was a blast to DPS. Mm-hmm.
Now, the thing that I'm looking
really
forward
was.
The thing that I'm really looking forward to, though, is with these changes basically reverting almost everything that was done with update 36, right? I'm really hoping and I'm looking forward to this carrying over and doing the exact same thing to PvP.
Oh, and a little soapbox. Everyone disrespecting Tunzo, go F yourselves. It's not cool. It's not cool at all. Just because technically we are reverting everything back to what Tunzo done. Tunzo was... He did everything. It's not like he just came in the game update 36 and it's like, oh, we're going to do this. And that's it. It's not... No, he was here from the beginning.
Yeah.
Doing everything and came up with these ideas. Again, these ideas or something new that it did not translate well to the players, because of course the advanced mechanics was not really explained very well. And I like maybe put 30% of blame on the developers for that. The other 70% I blame on the players for not going to DCO Blowguide, to not going to YouTube. It's your own fault. Your own fault for not understanding what advanced mechanics are when there's evidence out there for you to read. But don't disrespect Tunzo. I do not like seeing that. And yes, I will put a disrespecting meme on your replies. even if it gets banned, because sure enough, hand to God. And it might have been
check your stream. Check your stream.
Oh, of course, when I fucking rant.
Yep.
But I got the buffer. And offline.
I want my revenge animation back.
Yeah, I don't. That was the most useless change. That change right there was because he felt him on a personal level couldn't execute the move properly.
It was fine.
Mm-hmm. But just because he couldn't do it that way, he thought.
Give it back to me.
I'll be right back.
But can we talk about Aver? How awesome he is.
Yes, Aver, the new lead systems, doing good things so far.
Well, I just thought he did a great job of explaining things and answering questions and.
But I definitely Aver has I've seen him a couple of times on the Landmark streams because he worked on the Landmark, the EverQuest.
Mm-hmm.
And he did a good job there. So, I mean, he definitely has the mic and video persona that he can actually, he knows exactly what he's doing. And he definitely broke it down to us very well.
Yeah. So,
good on you, sir. Good on you.
But he did a really good
Aver,
job.
Yeah, Aver did a fantastic job. He's one of the new developers. Basically, from what the I got from the stream was he came in and they're like, hey, we're doing this. Here you go, and that's how he learned. That's how he learned the way the AM, the combat system, and everything.
Say, so, hey, is jump canceling coming back? No.
Is this show on the road? Oh, bring back jump canceling! Come on.
Oh, come
Let's
on.
Go.
No, I'll make an I quit video if jump canceling comes back.
I'm curious on what they're gonna do to some powers, like. Some moves like Mass Tear. I would love to see Mass Tear come back to how it was where it had that dot on it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'd like to see some things be reverted back to how they were, because I was thinking the other night, like, how to play mental, and then I'm thinking, like, oh, I'm kind of missing Mass Tear the way it used to be if I'm trying to build a loadout.
Well, I remember when I would mental troll, I would use Mass Tear as a CC.
So you can make the ads run all over the room?
Well, I mean, they would freaking, like, get stunned or like that. But, I mean, the tank could pull them back still, though. You know what I'm saying? But they weren't attacking anybody. You know, I mean, as...
No, I used it, too, once in a while. Just because it was fun. And I mean, sound it makes.
Yeah, oh, yeah. that shrill... run, you bastards! So, Aver definitely looks like he's done some great work here. He's definitely awesome. Also, who's that one dev Brit? The one that's always in the style thread? Megzilla.
Meg?
Megzilla, yeah. She's one of the artists, I think.
Yeah, if you guys got any style requests, go to the forums and hit up Megzilla.
Oh, wow, now you just opened up the floodgates there.
She's really involved in the styles thread on the forums. So definitely go check that out and hit her up there.
I got a style request. Make cosmic material on the color palette so I can make the stripes on my shoes cosmic.
Oh, they can't do that.
Oh, they can. Come on, don't tell me they can't.
No, they've come out and they said they can't do that right now. They come out and said that they cannot do that right now. Sorry. Sorry.
I don't believe that.
Well, he's in denial now.
I refuse to believe.
Krabby's in denial. Krabby's completely in denial. This, of course, has been the DCUO Sourcecast, your source for all DCUO news.
Did I ever say that line?
Community wise, no, you never did.
Huh?
No, you never did. I that's something I came up with on my own.
Huh?
You like that?
A little bit. A little bit.
You jelly? You jelly of it?
I'm a little bit. Yeah, I'm a little bit.
You can find us at facebook.com/thedcosourcecast. You can also find us on the Twitter at @dcosourcecast there. And you can find the audio version of the podcast at trexlight.com. Speaking of Trexlight, where can we find you at, sir?
You can find me over on the Twitter at @thisistrex, over on facebook.com/trexlight. You can find me on my YouTube channel, which I'll be getting back to later this fall, on youtube.com/trexlight. But just be sure to find me always on the Twitter. And follow me on my streams over at twitch.tv/trexlight. I don't know who to go to next.
Britt, where can we find you at?
You can find me on Twitter at PinkRanger_206 and on Twitch at Brittany_. I'll be right back.
And Crappy, now you've heard how they do it. Okay, where can we find you at?
You could type in crappy heels on the internet and stuff will come up. And it'll probably lead you to somewhere where I am.
What is this?
So he does it every freaking week. Drives me nuts. And of course, you can find me, Super Patriot, at youtube.com/thedaddyshouse, also on facebook.com/thedaddyshouse, Twitter at thedaddyshouse there, and you can find me here streaming the home of the DCO Sourcecast at twitch.tv/thedaddyshouse. I want to thank Trex for stopping in, uninvited, but always invited.
it really wasn't an invitation. There were demands on Twitter from and the Twitch stream asking me to be here.
Oh, really?
So, you know, yes.
All right. So, well, like I said, uninvited, but still always invited.
Ouch.
there was a double entendre right there. I did. You get it?
I know.
All right. But yeah, I want to thank Trex for stopping by. I want to thank Brett for stopping by. Hopefully, you know, maybe she'll come back as a regular. Who knows? We'll see. And of course, I want to thank my intrepid co-host, Crappy Heels, here for coming by.
You know who I want to thank? DC Universe for making nature great again. Shout out to DC Universe.
But yeah, thanks everybody for coming by and listening tonight. Sorry about the interruptions. There's one more thing I can try to do to make this a smoother internet, at least on my side, as far
have
as
Trex internet's concerned.
No, it's just, I need to
Wow.
Taking applications for a new co-host, folks. there's one more thing I can try and do on my end here to try to make the internet less impeding. I honestly do not feel it's my internet that's causing these interruptions during the stream.
It's all the porn. It's porn.
It's definitely not porn, dude. I mean, this is a brand new hard drive. I've got like no porn on it. You know, I mean, who downloads porn anymore? It's anywhere on the internet. You know, so
that's how you get in trouble down there.
Life lessons from the source cast,
especially the porn he downloads. So we don't want to.
Listen, man.
Too far.
That was a long.
I'm so
time
happy
ago.
The official DCO channel tweeted us.
That's awesome. But, especially want to thank everybody who stops by the stream to listen in, add their comments, and give their input, ask their questions and everything. We're always happy to help you guys out. Definitely spread the word about DCO Sourcecast and all that. Let everybody know, especially those guys in the Xbox, because they're going to need our help. All right? But, yeah, thanks again, everybody. I want to thank my hosts and my guests here for stopping by again. And until next time, though, you guys all stay classy. Bye.
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 Bye.